Hey, it's Gregg from the Code Creative. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use Gsap ScrollTrigger plugin with React. So let's get into it. By the way, if you're new here to the channel, we've got new videos coming all the time. So make sure you subscribe so you can take your coding skills to a higher and higher level every week. As you can see, I've got the terminal window open on my Mac, and I'm currently on my desktop, and I'm just going to go ahead and I'm going to run npx create React app, and then I'm going to give my application a name. I'm going to call it scrolltrigger-react. And I'm going to go ahead and hit enter, and that'll create the project on my desktop. Now that my project's been created, I'm going to cd into it. So cd scrolltrigger-react. I'll hit enter, and then I'll use the command code followed by a dot to open up the project in my code editor, which is VS Code. So now that the project's open in VS Code, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to open up the integrated terminal. And in the terminal, I'm going to run npm start. And now you can see that we can view our application in the browser at localhost port 3000. The next thing we should do, since we want to use ScrollTrigger, is go ahead and install Gsap. So let's go back to VS Code. I'll open up another terminal window here by clicking this icon. And then I'll run npm install gsap and hit enter. And now that the installation is completed, let's go ahead and let's open up our package.json file to confirm that we actually have gsap installed. And you can see it here listed in the dependencies. So we've got 3.9.1 here installed. And for your own reference, you can see the versions of React and React DOM that I have installed here, 17.0.2. What I want to do now is I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to close package.json, and I'm going to open up in the source folder the app.js file. And this file contains all of the DOM elements that we're seeing when we go to the browser. This animated spinning logo and this text, etc. So what we're going to do is we're going to get rid of a lot of these elements and just leave this image tag for now. So I'm going to get rid of the header, and then under the image tag, I'm going to delete all these elements. And so we're left with this outer and closing div and this image tag, which has the React logo as its source. So if I save now and go back to the browser, we just see the spinning React logo.
Oh, snap.
What we're going to do with Gsap and ScrollTrigger is we're going to animate this rotation ourselves. So what I want to do is I want to stop the default rotation that React is giving us so we can implement it ourselves. Let's go back to VS Code. And once again, in that source folder, open up app.css. And here on line 9, you can see this at media rule. And this is the one that contains the spinning animation for that logo. So let's go ahead and comment out this entire rule. Save and go back to the browser. And now you can see we still have the logo, but it's no longer spinning. So let's get this puppy to spin using Gsap. All right, so we can close out of app.css. And now we're going to be working in app.js. The first thing we want to do is we want to import Gsap from Gsap. And before we even use ScrollTrigger, we're going to animate the spinning of that logo just with Gsap. Now, in order to do this in React, we're going to use two hooks. Those are the useRef hook and the useEffect hook. And if you're not familiar with hooks yet, I have videos both on useRef and useEffect here on the channel, and I'll leave a link to those in the description down below. But anyway, let's move forward and let's import, then in curly braces, useRef and useEffect from React. So since the image is the one that we want to animate, let's give it a ref attribute, and we'll call it imageRef. And then what we need to do inside of our app component is we'll create a constant. We'll call it imageRef, and we'll set that equal to useRef initialized with a value of null. So one thing to keep in mind when using refs is that this name here, which we've called imgref or imageRef, needs to be the same as the name that we gave to the ref attribute. So the way that this works is that we initialize ref to null, but then once the component mounts, this imageRef variable updates to reference this image tag, which has the corresponding ref attribute on it. And then, as we're going to see in a second, we're going to use useEffect to work with this imageRef. So let's go ahead and let's work with useEffect now. Let's come into our app component, and we'll write useEffect and we pass a callback function to useEffect. And also, as the second argument, we're going to pass in an empty array. Now, the second argument, which is the array, is called the dependency array. And if we leave it empty, this callback function that we're going to fill out in a moment is just going to run once when the component is mounted. So it's inside of this useEffect where we're going to use Gsap. Once again, we're not using ScrollTrigger just yet, but we're going to get there in a moment. So inside of useEffect, the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to create another constant, and I'm going to call it L for element. And in order to use the ref, what we have to do is we have to say imageRef.current. That's going to allow us to reference this image element. And then we can use Gsap as normal. So if we wanted to create a tween, we could say Gsap. I'll use a method called fromTo. And the first argument here is going to be the element that we're going to animate, which we called el. And then next, we're going to create an object. This is going to contain our from parameters. And we'll create a second object. And this will contain our to parameters. So what we want to do is we want to get that logo to rotate. So in the first object, we'll say we want the rotation to start out with a value of 0. And in the second object, we'll have rotation go to a value of 180. And let's give it a duration as well. Let's say 3 seconds. So let's save, and we'll flip back to the browser. And now you can see that logo rotating. Let's refresh the page one more time to see it once again. There you go. So now that we see how to create a basic animation using Gsap, it's going to be real easy to incorporate ScrollTrigger. So we're going to install ScrollTrigger in a second, but first what I want to do is I want to actually create another div in my HTML, and I'll show you why we're creating this div. First of all, let's give it a class name, and we'll give it a class name of helper. And then let's go and open up that app.css file once again. And let's create a rule for that class of helper. What we're going to do is we're going to give this one a height of 100 VH. We'll give it a background color of orange. And let's save and let's go to the browser. And now I'm going to show you why we're creating this div. So the reason I created this div was so that we can get some scrolling action here in the browser. Since this has a height of 100 VH, now I can scroll down and see my logo come into view. Right? Because with ScrollTrigger, our animation is going to start when this logo comes into view. So we want to scroll down to it. All right, so here's the moment you've all been waiting for. Let's close out app.css and we'll come back into app.js. Now let's go ahead and we'll import ScrollTrigger into our file. So in curly braces, we'll do ScrollTrigger and make sure it's capitalized like this with a capital S and a capital T. And we want to import ScrollTrigger from gsap/ScrollTrigger. And then here's an important thing you got to do. You want to register the plugin. So we'll say gsap.register plugin and pass in ScrollTrigger. Now we're all set up to use ScrollTrigger. Here in our useEffect, let's come into the second object. And if you've used ScrollTrigger before, this is just normal ScrollTrigger stuff. We're going to say ScrollTrigger. And here we actually use a lowercase s. And we're going to set this equal to an object. And what we want to do is we want to give it a trigger property. This is going to be the element that's going to trigger the animation. And we want to set it to that logo, which is L. So we'll do L as the trigger. And let's save and let's go back to the browser once again. And now let's go and let's scroll down the page. And notice how once the logo comes into view, the rotation starts. Let's try it once again. We'll refresh the page. And remember, we set the duration for 3 seconds. So if we didn't have ScrollTrigger set up, at this point, that rotation would have finished because it's set to only last for 3 seconds. However, let's scroll down to it, and you can see once it came into view, the rotation started and lasted for 3 seconds. So in this video, we learned how to set up ScrollTrigger with React. Now in the description section and the comment section down below, I'm going to put a link to my free Google Search Tips for Developers cheat sheet, which I want you to download. And it's completely free, and it's going to teach you some ways to do better Google searches when you're searching for things like algorithms and syntax and so on. If you enjoyed this video, if you feel like you got some value out of it, please give it a like and subscribe to the channel so you can get more content just like this on a weekly basis. See you next time.